Seguimos en el TM Forum Latin American Summit, que se celebra en la ciudad de Sao Paulo, y estamos con el presidente de Amdocs para América Latina, con el que vamos a estar hablando un poco sobre su visión de la transformación de los operadores, porque ayer tenían un anuncio importante con un operador que es TIM Brasil, y vamos a preguntarle un poco para que nos comente un poquito este acuerdo que se firmó con este operador, para que podamos entender mejor de qué se trata. Patrick, welcome to Telesemana.
Gracias para su tiempo.
So you had an announcement yesterday with TIM Brasil. Why don't you tell us what this is all about, since we are in an event where we're talking about transformation all the time?
Yes, well, TIM we've been working with for some time, and we're doing a transformation of OSS there, which we announced last year, and also some production implementations of them. This win, which we announced here at the TM Forum, was really about helping TIM harness data, particularly with their acquisition of the broadband network. It's a 5,500-kilometer network.
Fiber network
that TIM acquired and are planning to launch new services on. And we think it's a significant advance for Brazil, for TIM, and for the telecommunications industry.
Okay, what are they trying to accomplish by using your solutions? What is the idea behind going with Amdocs?
Really to provide a better customer experience. And they're trying to have automated business process from the selling process, where they're approaching customers, to providing customer service, to billing, to cash collections. So really, they're looking to provide a better customer experience by having an integrated solution that supports end-to-end business processes.
Okay, what about integration? Because one of the things that we're hearing here is, okay, I need to move forward with my OSS and BSS. Sometimes some of the OSS, BSS components need to integrate each other or need to talk to each other properly, but I have a lot of legacy systems that I want to use or that I need to keep using. So I need, you know, different layers of software to integrate all these things. How does that implementation with you work? It's replacing stuff, it's just integrating things?
Sure. Well, we've done a number of transformations, both with existing systems and large-scale existing systems and integrating with legacy. But the value that we can bring is that we have an integrated portfolio, which removes a lot of the need for complex integration with heterogeneous legacy systems.
Okay.
And TIM, in the case of TIM, they have kind of a new fiber network, and so there wasn't a lot of legacy there to begin with. So they chose the best of suite approach, which provides integrated support for those business processes in order to deliver a better customer experience.
Okay, how does that integrate with the mobile network? Because we yesterday had here the CNT from Ecuador, and they have different lines of businesses, and they said, okay, we used to have a system for our fixed telephony services, we used to have another system for our mobile services, and now we're trying to have just an integration of the whole package into one, so we can do some crossover with different services.
Yes, in the case of TIM, we're really focused on the fiber part of the business right now. We see many operators, though, looking to provide multiple services to several customers. They want to sell all services to all customers and offer a broad portfolio of services, and as is the case with CNT and many operators. But at TIM, we're really focused on the fiber launch and delivering that capability to the marketplace to help increase the broadband penetration here in Brazil and, you know, elsewhere. We're working in Latin America because the broadband penetration is relatively low, and many customers are looking for new kinds of broadband services, and we're supporting our customers to deliver that to the market.
Okay, how would you compare the transformation we are seeing in Latin America with the transformation we might have seen in places with more mature operators like the US, Canada, or even some places in Europe or Asia Pacific?
Well, you know, in the U.S. And Europe largely have large infrastructures that are built, and in Latin America, in many cases, we're still in construction mode.
Okay.
So we see significant fiber deployments going on.
So that means it's simpler to do transformation because we have not...
In a way,
as much.
In a way, maybe there's not as much legacy, but what's really happening here in Latin America is consolidation. So the fixed and the mobile operating companies are converging mm-hmm. in order to be able to provide that wide array of services to the marketplace. So we're supporting, you know, that transformation and that consolidation process, and helping operators get synergies out of that consolidation, which we had experience from other geographies, including North America, over the last 30 years that we've been operating in the business.
Okay, so I guess there are some lessons we can bring from those markets.
Absolutely. The experience and the knowledge that we were fortunate to be able to gain from the large-scale consolidations that we've done elsewhere in the world, we're really in a great position to be able to bring that knowledge and experience to Latin America, American operators, and deliver them that value.
Okay, yesterday I think I heard somebody say, I don't remember who it was, that said that in Latin America there was a little bit of an issue because they had legacy services and systems that still were having a high demand, like, you know, basic services in mobile, for example, just voice and SMS. And at the same time, we had a growth in broadband, mobile broadband. In other markets like the US, perhaps, you know, operators are going to move much forward to new services and they're going to phase out legacy systems. And here, you're going to have both operating at the same time. Does that bring any level of complexity to the transformation that these guys are trying to?
You know, it was similar in North America. We had, you know, for many years, a large legacy that was in place. And, you know, our job is really to keep the plane flying while this transformation is going mm-hmm. on. And we've developed various transformation strategies, depending on what the operator and the customer situation is, to be able to keep certain parts of the legacy moving mm-hmm. while delivering existing services, while transforming to a 2B architecture, if you like, that supports the next generation of services.
Okay, and now that you mentioned the airplane, keep flying. Somebody said to me yesterday that it was important not only the transformation, but the speed of the transformation. I don't know if the speed, would you consider it a factor when an operator decides to go through this transformation? The speed at which it does that, it's a key component of that transformation.
Sure, time to market is critical for us and for operators, and we see that operators are continuously looking for rapid time to market for new solution delivery and value creation, because the faster we can deliver it, the faster we can create value for the customers yep. and the subscribers, as well as the shareholders.
All right. Well, Patrick, thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you very much.
And I'm
going
to let you go to your meetings. I know you have a very busy schedule here, so good luck with that.
Thank you for your time.